Speaker, I think you have already called for the consideration of item numbered as 4, which is the motion. You have already done so. So with the Minister responsible for finance and economic planning with us, I should think the time is due for him to move that motion. I should think, if you listen to me, I should think. Mr. Speaker, so the time is due for the motion to be moved by the Minister responsible for finance and economic planning. Thank you very much.
Honourable Speaker, honourable members of Parliament, I come in peace. On the authority of President Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo, I beg to move that this honourable House approves the financial policy of the Government of Ghana for the year ending 31st December 2017. On the authority of the President, and in accordance with Article 179 of the 1992 Constitution, permit me to present to this August House the maiden budget of the President of the Republic of Ghana. This presentation is an abridged version of the 2017 budget statement, and I would like to request the Hansard Department to capture the entire budget statement and economic policy. I also submit before this August House the following reports: the 2016 annual report on the petroleum funds in accordance with Section 48 of the Petroleum Revenue Management Act 2011, Act 815 as amended, the 2016 annual debt report in accordance with Section 72 of the Public Financial Management Act 2016, Act 921, and the 2016 Energy Sector Levies Report in accordance with Section 6 of the Energy Sector Levies Act 2015, Act 899. Mr. Speaker, let me first thank you and the House for approving my nomination as Finance Minister. My profound gratitude to both sides of the aisle. Thanks for the dry run of 3.5 hours. I pray that I'll be let off sooner this time. Mr. Speaker, I also stand here humbled by the President's courage and confidence to elevate me to this very weighty and high office of Finance Minister of the Republic of Ghana. Of the Republic of Ghana. I thank you.
Order.
I thank you. Of the Republic of Ghana. A nation with a manifest destiny for greatness, a nation with very high expectations for President Akufo-Addo's government, a nation that is 60 years old, remains a diamond in the rough, and therefore needs more than a shine. Mr. Speaker, it is this providential point in our history that I've been given this great but exciting responsibility to participate in sending Ghana beyond aid and to realize our birthright as a Black Star of Africa. I, Mr. Speaker, accept this role with all the solemnity and reverence that it deserves. Mr. Speaker, I would like to assure this House, as I also did with the Finance Committee, that I will work with members with utmost candor and respect. You are first and foremost the legislator, the representative of our people, and I have been privileged to witness the sacrifices you made in 2016 and gone through to be here. Are you cool? Secondly, Mr. Speaker, I am standing in the rather large size shoes of a legacy of family members, such as Dr. J.B. Dankwa, shoes of a legacy of family members such as Dr. J.B. Dankwa,
Honor.
Mr. William Ofori-Atta, Honorable Amwakwata of CPP,
Honor.
Dr. Jones Ofori-Atta, my father, President Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo, and Honorable Atachia. I have, Mr. Speaker,
honorable members,
I have, Mr. Speaker,
a conference with leadership. I may have to suspend sitting and have a conference with leadership if we are not in the position to listen. If this continues, this is what we have to do.
I have.
Read the budget.
Cousins and daughters
government. I have, Mr. Speaker.
By our standing orders, our procedures and tradition in this honorable house, this honorable.
A country where the private sector is well equipped to invest in the economy and be the catalyst of growth. A country where our youth have access to the requisite education which will expand their horizon and give them opportunity to dream and dream big and express their creativity, talents and ability. A country where each and every citizen is proud to be Ghanaian and to call. And to call this country home. Mr. Speaker, let me take this moment as we come to the end of this great privilege to present President Akufo-Addo's first budget to this August House. To reflect, Mr. Speaker, on one of the finest moments, in our history of our democracy on July 23rd, 1981. Mr. Speaker, as you all know, during the Third Republic, the country was in economic crisis under the government of the PMP. I am proud to say that my father, Dr. Jones Ofori-Atta, in your house, in opposition with an amendment motion co-sponsored by Dr. G.K. Agama, successfully got this August House to amend the motion to save the country in crisis. Honorable members, on July 23, 1981, honorable members, we do have a crisis. We do have a challenge. We can handle it, and I'll call on you, honorable minority, honorable minority leader Haruna Idrisu,
order,
honorable James Afeji, deputy minority leader, honorable Mankata Mubarak, chief minority whip, honorable Ibrahim Ahmed, deputy chief minority whip.
The budget is bad.
The Honorable The Honorable Second Deputy Speaker Bambagwin and the Honorable Ranking Members Atu Forsen and Fifi Kweto of the Finance Committee to join us in this great example of the Third Republic to salvage and build our economy together. We believe, with the help of the Almighty God, we can deliver on President Akufo-Addo's well-thought-out programs and policies and build a business-friendly and prosperous economy. Mr. Speaker, Mr. Speaker, I would like to remind you of the State of the Nation address when this President stated that the times in which we deem we live demand that we all be in a hurry to deal with the problems that we face. Mr. Speaker, honorable members across the aisle, given the great precedent set by the Third Republic, honorable members across the aisle, I enjoin you, please join me in this debate going forward to enrich it. Mr. Speaker, we can do it. I personally pledge to work with you, to work with candor, with transparency and respect, and an undying commitment on my part to protect the public affairs. To the people of Ghana, I pledge to serve you and to ask for your prayers. Mr. Speaker, the Lord did not give us a spirit of timidity, and we must confront these problems, but a spirit of power, of love, and of self-discipline. God, indeed, Mr. Speaker, we are at a crucial point in our history, and this is a nation that the Lord has blessed. God, indeed, bless our whole land, Ghana, make our nation great and strong. Mr. Speaker,
order, honorable members.
Mr. Speaker, I beg at this juncture to move the Asempa budget. Thank you.
honorable members, order. Order. Thank you very much, Honorable Finance Minister, for your delivery. Reference to the order paper and further to the order paper addendum. Is there any indication as to the presentation of papers, Honorable Majority Leader? At this stage, in accordance with Standing Order 140 sub 3, and within such time as the Business Committee may determine, debate on the motion shall stand adjourned for not less than 3 days. It is also directed that part of the budget relating to the ministries and constitutional bodies shall stand committed respectively to the committees responsible for the various subject matters and heads of the estimates and to report accordingly, further to Order 144. Furthermore, any part of the budget relating to revenue and expenditure shall stand committed to the Finance Committee in accordance with Order 140 sub 5. Honorable Majority Leader, any indication, both in terms of the order paper and the addendum?
Speaker. We have exhausted the agenda as captured on the order paper, but there is an order paper addendum on which has been captured papers that are to be presented in the House and would accordingly be done by the Minister responsible for Finance. Speaker. So you may allow for the presentation of the papers so stipulated on the addendum order paper.
Papers to be presented accordingly, including the annual report on the management of the energy sector, levies and accounts for the year 2016, annual reports on the petroleum funds for the year 2016, annual debt management report for 2016. Honorable Minister for Finance, I, annual report on the management of the energy sector, levies and accounts for the year 2016.
Annual report on the management of the energy sector, levies and account for the year 2016.
Annual report on the petroleum funds for the year 2014.
Annual report on the petroleum funds for the year 2016.
I annual debt management report for the year 2016.
Annual debt management report for the year 2016.
Honorable Majority Leader. The Minister. The relevant papers are referred to the Committee on Finance and any other indication, Honorable Majority Leader. At this time, will there be any other indication?
Speaker, the principal activity for today, as programmed, is the presentation of the budget to the people of this country through Parliament, and we have indeed done that. The Minister responsible for Finance, in accord with Article 179, has submitted to this House a budget that sets out to reposition Ghana on the path to real sustainable development, and which sows the seed to secure for ourselves and posterity the blessings of liberty, equality of opportunity, and prosperity. Mr. Speaker, what else can the nation expect from a budget? That indeed is the anticipation of the entire country. And Mr. Speaker, I do not think that this calls for a chorus, a discordant chorus as such, that this nation has witnessed. Mr. Speaker, we will stand the debate down until the appropriate time, and I believe justice will be done to the people of this country. After the dissection, we know what is in the belly of this budget. Mr. Speaker, on that score, I beg to move that this House adjourns proceedings until tomorrow, 10 o'clock in the forenoon. Mr. Speaker, I beg to move.
Honorable Minority. Order, order.
Mr. Speaker, I rise to second the motion for adjournment as moved by the Majority Leader. Suffice it to remind him and the Minister for Finance that when he was concluding, even though he began with a motion that this Honorable House approves the financial policy of the Government of Ghana for the year ending 31st December 2017, he concluded with, I beg to move the Asempa budget, not the matricule budget, not to the motion he himself submitted. And Mr. Speaker, I know that you have been affected by, I'm in a hurry, and you wanted many of these issues to. But Mr. Speaker, again, the Minister of Finance, in seconding the motion, when you come to this House of Record and use words such as, we have reduced the petroleum taxes, we have reduced the budget deficit, we have reduced the petroleum taxes, we have reduced the budget deficit. Mr. Speaker, Mr. Speaker.
Order.
You see, the Minister of Finance is before Parliament and is only honorable if he said that in this budget we have pledged to reduce, but not definitely that we have reduced. We have reduced. Mr. Speaker, we may take this for granted, but that Kayaye person wanting to enjoy the tax relief as announced by him and the spare parts dealer at Obosokai may ask for it in the next possible 1 hour of the relief we have reduced. But Mr. Speaker, The best assessment of a budget is not in its delivery, but in its outturn. We will monitor the outturn of the performance of the budget, and I beg to second the motion and to assure him that he has not reduced anything yet. It is subject to legislative reforms in this House, and we will do what is legally right because this is a country governed by laws. I beg to second the motion.
Mr. Speaker,
I don't want anybody to hear
me. Mr. Speaker, I thought what the minister meant was that the document that he's delivering to us contains these anticipations. So he has sought to do that. And Mr. Speaker, you see, people are eager to criticize, they don't have the patience to listen. That is why the difference between us and them is known to every Ghanaian. The difference between us and you, the way you are conducting yourself, it doesn't inure to the integrity of this House. It doesn't. I would want to believe that the question will be put and then we will debate the issues. I'm happy that the minority leader admits that the quality is in the outturn, not just the delivery, which should suggest all of us that is convinced and persuaded that the right thing has been done.
Yeah.
Don't be in a hurry to get up. Don't be in a hurry to get up. Mr. Speaker, I invite you to put a question. I'm up. I'm not down. The question should be put.
Honorable Minority Leader. Order.
Mr. Speaker.
Order.
Respect the chair, the speaker. Mr. Speaker. We know that rightly and pursuant to our standing orders, you are deferring debate and suspending it. But within 9 days, the fiscal deficit have changed from 9 to 8.7, and then the debt to GDP have changed from 74 to 73. He's not here in his own capacity. Mr. Speaker, you may accordingly adjourn the House. Interesting today, I will say.
Order. Honourable members, the motion for adjournment has been moved and seconded. All those in favour say aye. Those against say no. guys have it, the House will start adjourned tomorrow, 10 o'clock in the forenoon. Thank you very much, Honourable Members.
All right, so that's what we've been waiting for, and it's finally been presented to us, and this is the moment. The 2017 fiscal document talking about the budget for this particular period, and it's the first of the Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo-led administration presented by the Finance Minister, Ken Ofori-Atta, who is actually leaving the chamber now as we speak. He goes to exchange pleasantries with the minority leadership in Parliament. Just to give you a quick recall of some of the areas, and it's very, very clear. I'll be finding out from my guests whether what they heard addresses the concerns raised prior to this budget presentation that the NPP administration finds itself in more of a catch-22 situation. Well, the Vice President, Dr. Mahmoud Bawumia, who is the chairman of the economic management team of this particular administration, has also had to be here together with the members of the economic management team. Most of the time, if for those of you who watched throughout the period, saw the deputy, one-time deputy finance minister, at the time also occupied the minister, transport minister, Fifi Kwete, not agreeing with some of the things that were said there. I still have Professor Korte. He's the head of the Economics Department of the University of Ghana, Lagon, with me in right here at the foyer of Parliament. And also Edgar Redu. He's an insurance consultant and also a public policy analyst as well, joining us to talk about this. So, Alan, you see some of the ministers, Alan Chemanting, you see Trade and Industry Minister, also on your shots very recently. And also, as you have some other members of Parliament who at the moment interacting with the Finance Minister, Ken Ofori-Atta, who has fulfilled the constitutional mandate as bestowed on His Excellency the President, Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo. Specifically, Article 179 of the 1992 Constitution demanded that the President does it. This is what the Finance Minister has done for and on behalf of the President.